the sunny side of the scene. 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 Let's strengthen those quads. Okay, to do a squat, you're going to start with your feet hips distance apart. So you don't want to be out too wide and you don't want to be in too skinny. Exactly hips width apart. And you're going to sit down like you're sitting in a chair with all of the weight in your heels. And when you squat down, you want to make sure that your knees don't go over your toes. So it's going to look like this. Squat down and up. Squat down and up. All the weight in your heels. You can do a little booty shake and up. I like to sing, I fell in love in a porta potty line in the parking lot of some show. Woo! So you're going to want to do at least 3 sets of at least 10 squats each. Ready? Go! Because you know when you're on the porta potty, you gotta hold it there. And you're gonna give it a little shake. And stand up. Woohoo! I feel a burn!
Another thing that's extremely important is increasing your cardiovascular strength. There's nothing worse than being in the middle of a 15-minute jam and losing your breath. So you're gonna wanna find an exercise that you love to do that increases your cardiovascular strength, like running, dancing, power walking, whatever it is, find what you love to do and do it at least 30 minutes 3 times a week.
It should come as no surprise as it saved the stars to shatter. You learn to be.
Have you ever wondered how the Disco Biscuits prepare for Camp Bisco? Well, you don't have to wait any longer. Here's how.
Hi, I'm Brian. I'm an audio engineer. To get ready to camp for Camp Bisco on July 7th, 8th, and 9th, I practice tug of war.
Hey!
Yeah!
Nice!
Yeah!
Go, Brian, go! Go, Brian, go! Yeah, Camp Bisco!
Strong hands so you can hold on to the rope. So any gripping activities, holding on to a cold beverage, anything like that's going to help strengthen your hands. Another good thing to do is use good body mechanics. So you want to use your larger muscle groups. So you always want to think about sitting back, using your legs, your core, and holding on to the rope and leaning back. Otherwise, if you try to use your really skinny, wimpy arms like I did, you'll fall on the floor and fall on the other team. Do not do that. That is how you get really good at tug of war.
Thanks for checking out my workout. I'm Tara Lee Weathers, and this has been the Sunny Side of the Scene.